basically decent in these proceedings. I want to know whether counsel at the bar, one, can adduce this kind of evidence that is not contained in any evidentiary material before the Senate. I want to know which ground in the 11 grounds in the impeachment motion is this evidence from the bar supporting. I repeat, Mr. Speaker, we owe the Deputy President the most basic decency. I object.
Senior Counsel Orengo, those amendments, are they contained?
They are contained, they are all here.
They and refer to the document.
Volume 4. I am not referring because if I've got to refer to every document, will take a lot of time, and I have only 30 minutes. If you look at Volume 4 of this document on public participation, from
the Volume 4 of the National Assembly.
Of the National Assembly.
Pages?
Pages 114 to... Yes, and in fact, this page is also contained the will, and the Deputy President is the one who is relying on this will. The death certificate is contained on page 119. And it shows the only person who attended the deceased, the brother of the Deputy President at that time, was his daughter, was the only person present. And then there's the will. And in the documents on page 128, and this is why I was raising this matter, on page 128, there's a letter by Mr. Madenge and Mr. Njoroge Rigeru, who together with Mr. Rigathi Gachagua were the joint will executors. And they are complaining about the conduct and action of the Deputy President as an executor of the will and a family member of the late Nderitu Gachagua. On page 129, paragraph 8, and it says, from bank statements to this, for this account seen by us, you transferred some funds from this account to other persons as follows. On the date, on when Nderitu Gachagua died on the 24th, the Deputy President was already withdrawing money. On the day he died, and that day when he died, he was there only with his daughter. And then they say on the 19th of May, 2017, again, another money was withdrawn and paid to Mrs. Wamunyururu Investment Limited. This story, you will find it in the documentation. And part of it is what Mr. Njomo was saying.
Counsel for Deputy President, just have your seat. When your time comes, you'll be able to make the rebuttals. Proceed, Senior Counsel.
How many minutes do I have?
Mr. Speaker, I respect your direction. I'm willing to take a seat right away, but just to point out something. The document you are being referred to is the document you held in abeyance.
No,
because it was given to us later for purposes of our consideration. That's number one. Number two, Mr. Speaker, you remember that my learned colleague talked about how my client traveled to London, how without talking to any doctor. These are factual claims, Mr. Speaker, that are just coming from the bar. Mr. Speaker, number three, the opening statement speaks to the motion and the grounds in the motion. I beseech this House direct that parties restrict themselves to the motion and the grounds in the motion. The facts you are now being referred to have no basis in the motion and the grounds in the motion, unless the senior counsel, His Excellency Governor Orengo, can draw your attention to any ground in the motion that those facts are now addressing. I repeat what I said, Mr. Speaker, the ruling is yours. We owe it to the Deputy President and the integrity of our checks and balances institutions to maintain basic decency in these proceedings. I rest.
Counsel, I cannot